Okay, folks. Happy whatever day it is today. Monday. Happy Monday. And we're going to do some maintenance before we get started with our regular episode. And the maintenance I plan on doing is be able to find some of these paints a little bit easier. And it's really all about the AK paints, the AK airbrush paints. I'm having trouble locating them. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pull them out. I use them a lot when I go airbrush, and I take them out of here. They come in these sets, and I kept the boxes. I'm going to go ahead and put them back in these boxes. And that will pull them out of here, and I'll have a little bit more room there for the stuff. So I've got four sets. The German 1945 late German set, the 43-45, the 39-43, and then the Soviet camouflages. Okay, so we're going to put these, and then they're easy to find when I need to use these colors. They're listed on here what they have. So okay, so the original one, we got Dunkelgelb Shine. This is a mid-war one from a different set. Russian Brown obviously goes in the Russian set. Rot Brow goes in the late one. Chocolate Brown goes in the early one. Olive Gruen goes in the early one. Rosetta Green goes in the early one. Not the early one, but the one I bought first. Dark Green, I'm not sure which one Dark Green goes in. This is the base Dunkelgelb, which we put it hurting on it. And the light. One, two, three. I believe this is the six that come in the original set. Dunkelgelb base, Dunkelgelb light shade, the shine, that's these three. Chocolate brown, olive grün option two, and Rosetta grün. Okay. Good evening, David. And we're going to go ahead and put these back in the container, in the box, because I basically don't brush paint with these. Are you going to be a dickhead? Yes, they are. They're going to be a dickhead. All right. I don't brush paint with these unless I've airbrushed with them before. It's just going to make it easier to find them. And it'll free up some space there in my... But I was not expecting this type of difficulty. Obstinate bastards. Alright. Maybe you're the one that's the troublemaker. This is the hardest thing I've had to do in a week. What's wrong with me? Babysitting stuff all week, all day. I don't gotta do this too. Bastard. This goes in like this, and this goes in like this. Okay. 43-45 set. That's the first one that I got. And I was actually really disappointed when I got them because the colors don't match what I thought they were going to be. Okay, but I'm happy with it now. Okay. Mid-war Dunkelgelb goes there. I thought it was out of this set. It's not. Interesting. Interesting. Rock Brown is that one? Dunkelgelb Oust. 11 is this one. Russian tan. I wonder if that goes in the Russian set. Russian green. Another Russian color. Light green is this one. Protective green is over here. Washable white camo. I haven't even started messing with that. Gray base. Gray light base. I actually like the color I use for my gray. Green base here. Gel brown. The other Dunkel Gel color. It's like a lightning one. Sand growl. Matte varnish, okay. Gray shine, glaze medium doesn't need to be in here. These glazes, they can go up here. Kind of a specialty type thing. Russian brown. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, sand brow, right, Dunkel Gel mid-war, which I actually use quite a bit, gel brown, okay, the gray and the three grays. All right, let's do the same thing we did with them. That's going to free up some space there. This one has a freaking tray. Maybe the other one had a tray too. I don't know. Two down, two to go. I'm missing one color. Okay, I wonder if it's in here. Dark green, 915. Dark green, green base. Light green, work brow, and the two dunkles. One to go. I wonder if it'll fit up here. Okay. Don't mind being up there. Looks kind of nice. Okay. The box art's gorgeous. I mean, yeah. Russian green. 4BO. Yep. Russian brown. Yep. Russian tan. Yep. Protective green. Yep. Basic protector. washable white paint. Okay. Excellent. That freed up some space. So, let's go ahead and drop these greens in here. This is a new U.S. field drab. Along with the other one. White is in here. A couple new brown colors from Game Color. Greenlandia. Smooth the grays down. Free up some space in where the green colors are. I think we got all that sorted out. Now let's take these alligator clips. And just get so much shit in here you can't think. Spent too much time being distracted by things that aren't important. Scale stuff should go together. Let's put the decal film all the way in the back. I don't know if I'm gonna keep that panel line thing. One reason I picked it up is I had it there at the store, and I'm like, okay, well, that might be something that I might look to get in the future. No wonder it's a little dark. We're gonna be operating out of this side, I think, today. We gotta do more painting than building. So I found out some really interesting stuff since the last time I was on. And I don't consider myself ignorant of World War II planes by any stretch of the imagination. But there is a shitload of stuff I just don't know. Just stuff I wasn't even aware of. You know, I'm talking about like markings and stuff like that. I mean, I could talk all day long about Panzer Division markings and what color is this and what the Russians did or what we know or the Americans or stuff in the desert. I've looked at that stuff so many times. You can't help but remember those kind of things. But aircraft, I don't know diddly shit about aircraft. Because the last time I built aircraft, I was a kid. Basically, what that means is, I didn't fucking care. I mean, I just used whatever colors I had. I mean, they were painted reasonable. You know, it's like, wasn't painted a Focke Wulf in red, you know? But, it was grays, but... There's a lot of stuff I didn't know. And there's just a plethora of information out there now. I didn't have a clue. I didn't have a clue about any of this stuff. Ships? I know ships really, really well. I war game ships way too much. But aircraft, I played flight simulators, I built some models, that's about it. You know, I don't hate aircraft. It's just one of those things that just, you know, I didn't get to learn so much about it because I didn't gain as much. So, what did I learn?
Well,
let's look at the Spitfire. So, let me get my notes, which are in my wallet. And this might be common in other British aircraft as well, but if you look at this camouflage scheme at the top, and you think, oh, you could just use these colors, you can paint however the hell you can't, you want to. Oh, no, you can't. Well, I mean, you can, but then you'd be wrong. This camouflage basically came, I just learned this freaking today. I was today years old when I found this out, you know? One of those type of things. I was today's years old when I found this out. This came in two different versions. Basically, you've got green, and then also the flip side of it. Okay, so here you've got green in these spots, and this is what was called pattern A. Pattern B is the opposite. So pattern B would have green where the brown is, and brown where the green is. Okay, so basically, that's what it is. Pattern A was used all throughout the war. Pattern B was used at the beginning, and then it was discontinued late in the war because they wanted to speed up production. So when did they apply one versus the other? Well, they looked at the serial number of the plane, and if it was an odd number, if it was an even number, they put pattern A, like this one. If it was an odd numbered serial number, they would use the inverse of it. Didn't know that. So, you know, you got to stick to this. So if you're doing a bunch of Spitfires, half of them are going to be in the same pattern or so. What else did I find out? This paint scheme is really wacky, and they went through a lot of paint scheme things, but this is actually aluminum here on the bottom, and I thought this was, I didn't put two and two together. This is really how they were painted. Early in the war, one wingtip white, the other one black. I'm not so sure I'm going to do that. I don't know if I can live with myself. But they were repainted sky, which is an elusive color. And they ran out of paint. So it was a problem getting paint to them. Let me move the microphone. It's probably not in the best location. It's not in the normal location. So I had to feeding it from the other side. But they had paint problems. And they repainted some of the planes. But originally, when they were in France, they were like this. This is aluminum here underneath the nose and the tail and the fuselage. And then one wingtip was black and one was white. Looks kind of stupid to me, but, you know, maybe that's why they got kicked out of France. Yeah, a black underside, unless it's doing night activity, makes no sense whatsoever. And the jury's really out on some of these colors. So I was going to buy the Vallejo Air set for the British planes, and then I read some of the reviews and said the colors were really off. So that's why I did my own experiment yesterday. With the help of making my own paint chips, and with the help of the AK conversion chart, which actually wasn't that helpful. Let me make sure that we've got all the chat options on. Okay, perfect. You can get this online, akrealcolors.com, but I think this is basically AK patting themselves on their back, saying, hey, we make all these colors, and sometimes these other manufacturers match up. But here where there's nothing, nobody has this color other than us. Ooh, you know. But, you know, you can get close.
because I'm going to, I plan on painting the planes in a similar way that I paint the vehicles. We're going to give them some kind of a wash, and they'll look good, and they'll look equivalent to the vehicles. So, so one of these is going to end up being the brown, and one of these is going to end up being the green. Although I think it's U.S. dark green is what they said, an English uniform. So it could very well be these two colors to get the colors on the spit. And the interior is also here. The interior of the U.S. plane, interesting, I don't have a match for it, but I have pictures. We live in a land of pictures and fuselages and of stuff on the internet. So that's what I have to do next painting wise, unless we're going to mess with one of these vehicles, which I may do that, is paint the interior of the two planes. So I think what I'm going to do is, let me look in the drawer here. And see if I can find all the extra wheels. If I can find the extra wheels, I mean, if I can find them quickly, let's put it that way. It's not like they're lost or anything. I probably cannot find them on demand. Is this the other panther? This is the other beautiful panther by Plastic Soldier Company. We're going to paint the interior of the aircraft. So, and based on the difficulty of these two paint schemes, I really should do the P-40 first. Because the P-40 is significantly easier than the other one. So I'm going to grab all the parts that go with the P-40, which are just this right here. And, I'm going to be right back because I'm going to take my contacts out. It's a lot easier to operate with these small things with my contacts, so I'll be right back. So the whole point of me building two aircraft at the same time is this is kind of uncharted territory. And there's some things that I've got to do that involve making sure I don't get discouraged before I finish my first aircraft. I don't know what not being happy with how it turns out yet is because I haven't made one yet. So, you know, I gotta do shit like this to feel comfortable with it, okay? That's why we're doing two. Yesterday I learned you can get rid of the heart. Has to be done on your end, but should remain offer. Okay, so what do I do? Because I'm stupid when it comes to this kind of technology. I'm a painter, damn it. Not a space shuttle conductor. I don't even know how I know that saying. Because I don't even like science fiction. Much less science fiction with silly uniforms. Let's see if I can put this here. Okay. I need some. I am so unmotivated to learn how to do Streamlabs better. I really just don't give a shit. You know, because they fuck with things too often. Okay, so this is going to be the interior of the cockpit. That's going to be painted the interior green color. It's called zinc chromate, I believe. And we're going to find it based on the colors I have. And I'm going to make a pretty good approximation of it and have ultimate confidence that I'll be able to pull that off. And we're going to have a visit from the wet palette, which is probably moldy as fuck at this point. Because this thing hasn't been opened in, God, it seems like probably a month. Yeah. What do I know? Not that bad. Searched on YouTube, removed the heart from YouTube Live and saw a short tutorial. Looks simple enough. Okay. Well, hopefully I don't have to do it at the beginning of it. If it's something I can do right now, I'll do it. It's bugged the hell out of all of us, hasn't it? Yeah, this thing's pretty moldy. Damn it, I want to get this show started. All right, I'm going to take a small recess here. And I will be right back after we deal with the situation. Okay, now. Now I gotta. Hopefully, I know where my papers are. Well, let me go where they should be. They should be in one of these drawers. And they're not there. Okay.
Find a cardboard stash. Cardboard stash. Awesome. Excellent. And a pair of scissors. Have to operate without them. Not that big of a deal.
No point in closing it up. All right. Twenty-three Polish infantry. All to be mowed down by a Panzer I. Bah! We're going to use a green type color. Let's use black. You're lucky I didn't find those tires. I'd be doing the Puma right now. The Puma, your Puma is my Hellcat. I hate the Hellcat. It's ugly as shit. I don't mean the M18. I mean the F4, or whatever the hell it is. Whatever the hell it's called. Oh, these are filthy. Okay. So let's go to the greens. So if you look at the inside of a P-40, this signing into my own damn phone is driving me bananas. I've never had security on my phone before, and I just thought, well, maybe it's a good time to do it this time, and I'm literally going crazy. P-40 interior color. Okay. It is an unattractive green. So, I am certain I have a color that would go with that.
Before I just start pulling colors, I have my paint swaths that I actually made. Man, I'm all over the fucking place. I need to have two lines of coke to get back in line here. Let me go out to the garage. I must have left it out there. so much to me because I'm going to be doing my layering technique. So I'm not so worried about getting the color exactly right because I'm going to end up tinkering with it anyways. Might as well bring some of those back also. All right. This is what I did way back when, where I took all of my Vallejo paints and I put a little swath of them all. So, I'm not going to read what I found online because it basically was inconclusive. So this olive green and this German camouflage bright green are two candidates, and so is this golden olive. Okay, so let's pull those three out. Golden olive. That's the olive green. SS camouflage green. That's this one, right? 80, yeah. That's the three. And this is why I store them on the end. It's easier to get a kind of an idea of what color it is. Now, of course, we're going to mix black into these colors anyways. That one's kind of fading. Which one of these three is the least bright? Not golden olive. You just got kicked to the curb. Okay? SS camel bright green. And olive green. I'm going to go with olive green. All right, so I'm going to look at P40. P40 cockpit interior. And you get lots of little stuff on here. Now, importantly, does this one come with a decal? Or is this the one that actually has the stuff molded on? Because it makes a difference how I'm going to go about it. Okay, this has the stuff molded on, all right, which would be really minuscule for most people, but I'm used to that. So it's going to be on a black base. Okay, all the controls on the wall for the most part are going to be green, so that entire wall can be green. All right, let's get some of this out and start doing our magic. I don't hate the Puma, I just don't care for it much. German camouflage green is probably the best match. Hey, Marcus! Seems a little too bright. Doesn't matter. Doesn't matter a whole lot because I'm going to we're gonna do the stuff that we do, which is add black and so forth. Oh, this is a crusty ass color too. Where's the black at? I'm gonna really throw a wild card out here.
I might have considered actually going to Mitch's tonight had I gotten to leave work at the time I'm supposed to leave work. But since I was basically an hour and a half behind, I'm like, fuck it. I ain't doing it. I'm not going to run around and then be up too late and screw up my whole week.
Here we go. This is what we want to use.
Yep. This is the color that we want. With a little bit of the SS Camo Black. All right, let's get the Flow Aid. One drop. Jeez. Oh, this thing broke? Can't have anything nice. Now we'll get a little bit of black here. I enjoy painting on the weekends so much more. Start with that. And we're going to paint I'm really not sure where it begins and where it ends. I'm actually going to go a little bit darker than that. And then we're going to go over the whole area. Trying to not get it on the instrument panel. Green zinc chromate, I believe, is what it was called. I'm going to have it on this one little ledge right here. Okay. And the same thing on the other side of the plane. And I think everything in here. One 700 scale is too big for gaming? Well, it depends what you're gaming. I don't know. Have you seen the guy? Is it Yorkshire Gamer? That plays, he's doing like a Bismarck type thing, or he was doing it last year. All in 700 scale. So, 700 scale Bismarck's like freaking this big, but like the destroyers. And problem is, you have to really condense the scale of them, of some of the ships, of the gameplay. But it looks good. I still haven't gotten a chance to watch Godzilla Minus One. Speaking of ships. I was reading about Japanese cruisers the other day, maybe even today, and I came across the Tone, which was sunk in Hiroshima Harbor in July. And I'm sitting there thinking, wouldn't that be terrible? You have some ship that sinks, like before they got a chance to salvage it, it gets nuked. But I don't know if the fireball made it out into the bay or not. I want to put together a 700 scale ship, but some of the little tiny things makes my hand shake just looking at them. I don't have that problem yet. But then I'm always painting and doing stuff with my on a rested surface. Doing shit in the middle of the air would make, I'd shake too. The chair itself, oh, I shut my damn phone down. I mean, that's a really good view of what's going on there. So the joystick's aluminum, the flight stick, the joystick. Well, if you're shooting a lot of Japanese planes down, it is a joystick. I'm gonna say the whole seat is this color. And we'll come in and we can paint a cushion or something like that in there. But at least initially. I remember when I first saw this plane, I'm like, man, the tiger shark mouth is really cool, but I don't know about what's this weird ass sun symbol. I've never seen that before in my life. You know, nationalist China, I didn't know what the hell it was. I may actually have to go back and rebuy this color. Some of these colors are just, they're old. I really didn't even use them when I got them. And now they're like 20 something years old and they're just not, they don't behave great. And it's mainly the weird colors. Colors that really don't get a whole lot of use. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and ditch this. We're gonna use a brush that to get some more detail. I'm gonna get rid of these Nazi dickheads that are in my way.
Now, most of this you're not going to even see anyways, but... We're going to take this all the way back. I don't know right off the bat what part of this will be seen and what part won't be seen. And we may have to scrape some of this stuff when we assemble this. This is kind of uncharted territory, but I know we're going to knock this shit right out of the park. May not look as good as that Tiger 1. That's going to be hard to freaking replicate. That Tiger 1 just came out really, really well. But I painted over 100 vehicles before I came up with that, so. Go get my 3D print. If you get the one for 2002 print, there's face of cam dungeons. Avoid getting paint on the joint parts of the fuselage. You will need to scrape it off. You could test fit the halves and look down and see where the parts.
Yeah, I don't think I have it on that. Yeah, I know what you're talking about. I actually test fitted it yesterday. Really wanting to sand that whole thing down, but it can wait. I'm having second thoughts about maybe getting a flight stand for these. I don't know. I could certainly put a little magnet in there, and then a magnet on the flight stand, and
I really need to stop putting black paint on this black thing. Because I keep thinking, oh, okay, that's the color that's the Flow Aid. Even though I just dipped the Flow Aid before. Man, what the hell is in that coffee I made?
I definitely needed to have some coffee because I was falling asleep. And falling asleep at 7 p.m. just isn't going to cut it. You know, I've spent all day doing shit I don't want to do.
Probably more than anybody, I'm not so worried about getting the right color. Initially, because I'm going to be doing this blending, I'm going to be doing this layering shit anyways. So. Looks like there's a little bit of padding on there, but they didn't give me any. I'm not gonna go freaking rebuild it. Let's visit the site.
I got somebody that contacted me last week and was like, oh, how come you're not playing DBA? I said, man, I only mentioned it all a million times. I'm not making a video about it. The only reason I'm not making a video about it, I don't really want to kill the community. It's not about that. You know? I don't hate the community. I'm just... It's time to move on. I wouldn't be doing all this stuff if I was still doing DBA stuff. Let's take a little bit of No, we're gonna use white. This is gonna be only a tiny little bit. But there was a question that was asked on one of the Facebook forums just in the last week about something that's been hashed out so many times already. And it's like, you know, I'm not saying the person's... I'm just tired of that stuff. I'm tired of unsolvable issues. Looks pretty good. That looks pretty good. Just for yucks, okay. Now the seat part. Miss Tokyo. Did you ever get Subway stuffed? don't see a cushion or anything, so I'm just going to leave that off. The problem is these colors are really glossy. Really glossy. So when I hit this with the flat, it's going to look significantly different, I think. Joystick or the flight stick is silver and the end is black. Okay. On that plane, anyways, on this one, it's painted the same color. Now, I'm going to make it silver just so it stands out. There'll be something of interest to look at. So, let's get a color. It's a blast from the past. You should still be alive. I didn't touch you. Get your ass back in there. Mithril Silver. Still alive. After all these years. If you're wondering why I'm getting so anal retentive about this, I'm going to do this right. I'm going to do this right. We may not do it on another plane, but we'll do it with this one. I'm not going to put a pilot in there, so. Probably have to buy an aftermarket pilot. Some of these pilots that come with a models are pretty shitty. Okay. You've been Subway stuffed. It was very kind. Japan is like, as an outsider, a land of extremes. They're like super respectful, and then they let themselves get, you know, manhandled by, you know. I guess they're using white gloves, so it makes it all different. It's just really weird. Bend over and get stuffed. Now, let's see how this looks on the inside. This is going to go there. I'm not going to be able to do that with this. I don't think the back of this is visible. Okay, well, the interesting thing I found out is some of this green would be noticeable down here. I don't like the idea of going through on a subway in a place that has horrible earthquakes. Just nothing, that's just a bad equation. That's a bad equation, so far as I'm concerned. Like going in a tunnel or something like that. I'm like, oh no. No, 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 no. Okay, this is gonna go there. Okay, now we won't have any visible there, cool. And then on the other end, this will go like this. And we just need to paint this area as well. I think I was being very liberal with leaving extra space in there that wouldn't be seen, but I think I needed to be even more. All right, let's look at. I don't know what color this is supposed to be, but I'm going to go ahead and paint it. Okay. Let's look at these controls. What do they look like? They look like I need to do some dry brushing.
Yes, polite and precise. I remember waiting outside a convenience shop once for opening. I was the only one waiting. The woman waited till precisely 8 a.m. 5 minute wait, bowed, and then let me in.
Well, that would probably happen here without the bowing. I'm not a fan of the bowing thing. That's a little... I've issues with subservience type things. I know it's a cultural thing, but you know, nobody. I don't need to bow to somebody. They don't need to bow to me. People don't need to call me sir. I don't need to be knighted. You know? I have problems with the subservience thing. That's why I hate those mask things. I don't give a shit about the vaccine. It doesn't bother me. The mask, you can't see somebody's face, man. Like you're doing something dishonest or something. Okay. Let's start off with gray, okay? And I'm going to make my own gray. I thought Academy is Japanese, but I guess they're Korean.
I enjoyed it. I even knew quite a bit of language at your peak.
That's not bad. I mean, it's not going to be able to do, I'm not going to be able to do better than that without spending, you know, a fucking week on the control panel. I think it's that would be extreme. That would be extreme. Okay. Let's look at the instructions.
Oh, that's Spitfire instructions. Look at the P-40 instructions.
Put all the stuff on there. Yeah. Okay, we got some parts to put the two halves together. They go on one side or the other. We got all the part. We got this, the dash here. So we're going to go ahead and attach it to this part on that side. 11. What color is all? This color guy isn't freaking great. Neutral gray. Okay, so they want me to paint the inside of this intake neutral gray. I'm not going to do that because I can get to it afterwards. Okay, I'm not worried about that. I just knew that I needed to get the cockpit pre-painted or I'll be up a creek. Okay, so we need piece D9 and C18. Okay, this is C18. Okay, and
the Tamiya clippers are over here.
And so is the glue. is C18. And then D9. Is here.
Okay. And then we put the two halves together.
Okay. We're going to glue this all on this side. This piece goes here. This goes like on top of it. Oh, that's interesting. Well, that's a shame that they've got this little. Should be like this. Nope, there's a little notch for it. Wow, it doesn't seem to fit. Okay. We'll get it in there. Thin that out, and we'll do the same thing with this side back here. It's close, but as it stands, it's not going to fit in there. Okay, there we go. Now, we'll go back to where we were. I guess we should probably put this one in as well. Okay, and then the two halves should go together. So let's test for fit. Make sure the fit. I already tested for fit earlier. Let's just make sure that we are on the right page. Now, fortunately, in looking for those wheels I found something else that is really helpful. And I would not have known where they were, but I found them. And that's the Bubba Rans. I'm going to use the restroom and I'll be right back.
So now we're going to put the two...
Well, we can't do that yet. We got to put the seat in. Install this from the bottom. That'd be kind of cool. Well, let's just do a dry run. Let's pretend it's glued. It's not, but boy, that's plenty limpy. Let's use a tire on. These are some of my daughter's hair ties, so. Let's say this one is. Let's say we had glue on here, okay? And while this is setting, I got the wild idea of setting this in from the bottom. Would that work? I think so. What's it look like? Well, you can't see anything that's not green. That's a good sign. You could see stuff back here, but if I have to repaint it, I can reach it before I find out that this is actually showing some of it. So, yeah, it looks okay. Probably could have painted an instrument panel like this. But yeah, that's what we're going to do. We're going to install that thing from the bottom. Okay. And actually, better than rubber bands, I have something in the garage.
To pick some of these up at the fabric store and then didn't, but then realized that
they actually have these that came with the airbrush, and that's pipe cleaners. Okay, so let's put the two halves together. And I think exception of that, which I'd be able to reach anyways, we shouldn't have any paint in the way. We're going to take one of these pipe cleaners This should work. I've thought about this long and hard. And then do the same thing back here. Put some Bubba Rans here for good measure. Let's hold that in place. Give it a twist. Well, in theory it sounded good. Who knows if I can actually pull it off. Put it on both sides, but maybe I gotta put it on this one. And yes, I did wash the model. Stuff I've never washed a model before, ever. Decided to wash the model. I've never painted the interior of a plane before assembling. I decided to paint the interior of a plane. You're back.
I used to build planes when I was younger and hang them from the ceiling in my bedroom when fishing line and thumbtacks. Me too.
You won't be doing that because I'll get full of dust. I mean, the fit of this thing is pretty darn good. Yeah, that's okay. What I don't agree with is people that have this. Oh, when I was a kid, I used to build things and blow them up with firecrackers. Like, no. No. Not blowing things up with firecrackers. No, thank you. Now. That didn't work. Let's try this again. Catch the inside of this one too. And we'll do this. And we'll do the equivalent one here. And the underside here, and the underside on the other side. Oh well, the pipe cleaner thing worked in theory, I guess. So then we put the seat in, and then we're going to install the area that goes behind the seat. I like weld cement. In theory, when you're done, you have you go from 60 pieces or however many pieces are on the model to one piece. It's all one piece welded together. In theory. All right. Drop the seat in from the bottom. That way I can center it and it's supported on both sides equally. Let's make sure it fits okay. I'm going to use super glue to drop it in there. I should be able to drop it in there using a pair of tweezers. And let me grab my super glue. Just make sure it's operating correctly. Yep. I'm actually going to squeeze some of it there. Here and here and here and here. And I'm going to take this. Now, I didn't have any of this stuff when I was a kid. I mean, just something as simple as tape. I didn't have tape. Let me make sure there's some pressure on that right now for the time being while it. We don't have any surprises. Okay, we're doing the P40N, so we need piece C8.
Okay.
C8, right here. And it has like an antenna, which we're not going to add right now. Because I don't want that to possibly break off while we're doing all this other procedures. Check how much of this green is hidden. In other words, make sure that there's nothing showing. It's not green in the green area. Okay, and this fits like this. And there is nothing that is not green showing there. There's nothing in the area that should be something green showing there. So we can go ahead and attach that on there. Okay. Okay. Yeah, I don't want to fool with that antenna being there. That can wait until the very end, until we get ready to paint it.
Leave the tape holding the fuselage together for the cement.
Okay. The wings. Top and the bottom wings. What's next after that? Landing gear and such. This thing's in the way. I mean, this has really good detail on it. And unfortunately, olive drab is such an ugly color. But I think we can I think we'll be able to make this look pretty darn good. Pretty darn good. Let's just get close. Want to use any filler on this if I can avoid it. All right, let's go in here with supervision now. don't know if I'm going to use that Tamiya lining stuff. I may just return it. I think that's going to be a little too drastic. Sand that together, and once we have both pieces on there, let's check for fit on here. Oh, we gotta do this. Guns fit in here. Yeah, they're far enough away from the guns. I can handle that. Doing that. God, this is really, really nice. It's
get sanding sticks. I can't. The place is closed. Maybe this weekend, coming up. I couldn't get sanding sticks. I'm working all day.
I couldn't even leave at my designated time I was supposed to leave today. Pain in the frickin' ass.
Well, didn't get to see Mitch then.
I'm not going over there on a late start.
That makes it even more likely to show up there late, stay way too late, and fuck up my whole week.
Oh, let's learn our lesson.
Not really a lesson, but
what's going on, Justin?
I can't. The grocery store is closed.
I probably do need those sanding sticks. They're kind of... I could probably get away with not using them, but...
I was finally able to unlock the Scharnhorst and what's that stupid thing called? World of Warships, and then don't have the cash to buy it.
Don't have the game cash, because I don't spend real money on shit like that. That's just stupid. Not my kind of thing. I could probably even handle having a fingerprint. Putting that accidental fingerprint on here, I'd still probably be able to salvage that. I don't want to, though. I don't want to do it wrong. It just creates more work for me. As a kid, I would have used that thick ass tube glue shit. That isn't worth a damn. Thick ass tube glue shit. I almost want to buy like a toy plane. What'd I do? Still got some on there? Fuck you. So barely noticeable. Almost want to get a toy plane and test my theory of how I'm going to paint this. I may actually do that. This is kind of a pain in the ass to put something back together or repaint it or something like that. Ho-ho! Well, that didn't work out well. The bond of the tape was stronger than the bond of the superglue. Well, I'll epoxy your fucking ass. See it because I don't have my contacts in. That's the only reason why. This fits in here really tight. Like, really well. It's actually kind of a narrow wing, now that I'm looking at it. It's kind of narrow. Okay, well, we're going to sand the two bits together before we... we do this, but I'm going to let this cure before I mess with that. Yeah, we'll epoxy that tomorrow or so forth. I think this is where we're going to stop for the night. We got what landing gear to put on there? Yeah. Anyhow, work on our way through it. Gorilla glue. I hate Gorilla glue. No, no, I'm putting the tape over the bottom because I wanted to hold it in place. Yeah, there'll be tape over the top when we go to paint it. All right, folks.